You know what are the halogens? The chalcogens are oxygen family, oxygen, sulfur, and the selenium, tellurium, polonium. Halogens are fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, acetate. So the chalcogens, oxygen, sulfur. So here the chalcogens oxidation state, common oxidation state is minus 2. Common oxidation state of chalcogens, you say oxygen, you say sulfur. For example, oxygen will be minus 2. We write oxide, oxide ion. We write sulfur. What do we call this is? Sulfide ion. Sulfide ion we write. Selenide, telluride, polonide. As we move from the oxygen to polonium, the negative oxidation state decreases, the positive oxidation state increases. Anybody say why the negative oxidation state decreases, the positive oxidation state increases down the group? Similarly, if you observe in the fluorine, fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, acetine, the common oxidation state is minus 1. Since these are most electronegative elements, common oxidation state is minus 1. But the fluorine will form fluoride ion, F minus, chlorine, chloride ion, bromine, bromide ion, iodine, iodide, acetyl. So, but if you observe the oxidation state of the fluorine is a fixed in all the compounds, the fluorine oxidation state is a minus 1. But if you observe the oxidation state of the chlorine, bromine, iodine, acetyl is radioactive, polonium is radioactive, we won't consider. But chlorine, bromine, iodine. So these are the elements exhibit the oxidation state plus 1, plus 3, plus 5, even plus 7 also.
Yes, sir.
So if you observe the sulfur, sulfur exhibit plus 2, apart from the minus 2, plus 2, plus 4, plus 6, plus 2, plus 4, plus 6, the chalcogens exhibit the oxidation state. Whereas the halogens exhibit, apart from this negative valency, they show the positive valency also, plus 1, plus 3, plus 5, plus 7. Tell me the reason why these elements, sulfur, chlorine, bromine, iodine, except oxygen, except this fluorine, rest of the elements have the positive oxidation states. Can anyone say the reason? What could be the reason for this to exhibit the positive oxidation state? Do you suggest any reason why particularly chlorine, bromine, iodine, why particularly sulfur, selenium, tellurium exhibit the positive oxidation state apart from the negative valency? So the answer comes, what is the reason means? So these elements, sulfur and the chlorine, bromine will have nearby empty d orbitals. So electrons can be, the electrons present in the p orbital can be promoted into the d. Means the valency can be expanded, The oxidation number can be expanded due to the availability of d orbital. Where in case of the fluorine, in case of oxygen, absence of d orbital. Absence of what? D orbital. So, if you observe the chlorine oxidation states, for example, if you take HClO4, what is the name of this compound? HClO4. What is the name of that compound? HClO4, this is called perchloric acid, right? This is perchloric acid. And in this, if you want to assign the oxidation state of this chlorine, according to this oxidation number rules, so this compound, total compound, means sum of the oxidation states of the atoms of elements equal to 0. That means HClO4 compound, if it is a neutral, means it's the sum of the oxidation numbers of the atoms of elements present in this compound is equal to how much, means 0. Their algebraic sum. Their sum of the oxidation numbers or their algebraic sum is equal to 0. If the compound is a neutral. So, that means some of the oxidation states of the elements present in this compound is equal to 0. And 0 indicate what means? This compound is a neutral. Their total oxidation states, their algebraic sum is equal to 0. That means, so here I want to find the oxidation state of the chlorine. What I have to do means, if you want to know the chlorine, means you must know the hydrogen, you must know the oxygen. As you know that hydrogen, so in this compound will form the plus 1 sum, means plus, because hydrogen and chlorine assumed to be X. Then oxygen will be, oxidation state is minus 2 fixed into 2 into 4 is equal to 0. Now you got the algebraic equation. Now you got algebraic expression of this compound. Now find out what is the X value. What is the X value? Is it plus 7? Yes? Are you listening to me? Am I audible? Body is visible?
Yes, sir, you are audible.
So,
yes, sir, you are.
X value positive number aayega, negative number aayega, batao.
Positive.
So plus 7. The plus 7 is the oxidation state of the chlorine equal to its group number, equal to its valence electrons. So now I will give the one more compound of the Cl2O7. Cl2O7, okay. So find out the oxidation state of the chlorine in this. So algebraic equation according to that. So Cl2O7 equal to 0, since it is a neutral compound. I want to find out chlorine multiplied with 2 plus, so between the two elements sum we have to take. The oxidation state of oxygen how much? Minus 2 into how much? Atomicity 7 is equal to how much? 0. Find out what is the X value. Yes.
7.
Yeah, positive number and negative number x equal to.
Positive.
Positive number. So in the chlorine oxide, higher oxide, oxidation state is a plus seven, and in the what we call means oxo acid of the chlorine, its oxidation state is +7. Right. So now, tell me what is the name of this formula written on the board. So what is the name of this compound?
Sulfuric acid, H2SO4.
Sulfuric acid.
Sulfuric acid. Pata karo sulfur ka oxidation state how much? How much will be the oxidation state of the sulfur in this compound? Some of the oxidation states of hydrogen sulfur oxygen is equal to 0. So make the algebraic expression for this. So here is sulfur is assumed to be X. You know the hydrogen is +1. Oxygen is -2. Sulfur is X. So +1. So between the hydrogen and sulfur, +1 into 2, no?
Yes, sir.
+1 into 2 plus sulfur is X plus oxygen is -2. Atomicity 4 multiplied with 4 is equal to 0. Aapko algebraic expression banaya. Then what will be the x value? +6 aayega, -6 aayega, batao.
Yes, sir. The +6.
+6. So the sulfur loses electrons with oxygen, with hydrogen. So +6. And if you want to look at the structure of this sulfuric acid, sulfur will make double bond with oxygen, neighboring oxygen, like this. Here is one single bond, here is oxygen. Here will be the hydrogens. Here will be the hydrogens. Now number of bonds, how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 bonds are there. See,
yes,
so as per the oxidation state, competitive transfer of electrons takes place from sulfur to oxygen, because oxygen is more electronegative, sulfur is electropositive. Comparison, if you compare, relative. So then between sulfur and oxygen, there is a polarity. Between oxygen and sulfur, there is a polarity. So that's why we have to use oxidation number, oxidation state. Okay, so this is the structure of sulfuric acid. Sometimes in the formula, one element will be repeated. Or, okay, now this is that neutral molecule, and in the neutral molecule, see, if I write sulfate -2. This is ion. Now, in this ion, what happened? The sum of the oxidation state is equal to -2. Not zero. Not zero. Because this compound is not neutral. This compound is not neutral. That's why in this ion, so if you want to find out the oxidation state of the sulfur, X plus -2 into 4 is equal to -2. Then what will be the X?
6.
Yes, positive number 6. So sulfur group number mila aapko. The oxidation state is not limiting. It's a group number. Sulfur belongs to 16th group or 6th A group. And So it is not, the oxidation state should not exceed the group number. Okay, so now again, what happened if the in the compound? What is the compound? You know, you can take the compound is Cr2O7-2. And in this compound, chromium is repeated. Chromium is repeated. I want to find out the oxidation state. Oxidation state or oxidation number. Sometimes we use the word oxidation state, oxidation number. So synonymously we use oxidation state of the chromium. So X into 2 plus minus 2 into 7 is equal to minus 2. How much will be the answer?
Plus 6
aayega.
Yes, sir.
So
yes, sir.
That means in the compound, if you get the repeated identical atom, if you get, we should take the average. So then we have to look for the structure. The dichromate ion structure will be. Here is the oxygen, third, 4 oxygens, 5th, 6th, 7th. Now here, oxygen valency, how to, here is the double bond, here is the double bond. And so, here is one minus one charge, here is the minus one charge. Now we have to check 1, 2, 4, 5. One more double bond here. One more double bond here. So this is the structure of, that means here chromium is plus 6. Here is the chromium is plus 6. Chromium plus 6 here. So hence, so chromium oxidation state on the two places, plus 6, 6 plus 6. By 2, you will be getting 6 only, average. We should consider average. Yes, tell me.
Sir, how come those two above oxygens have only single bond here?
Single bond, see, this is ion, no? That means, here if you write Na2, okay, Na2, sodium dichromate, where would you place the sodium?
With oxygen.
Yes. Now here sodium will come, no, here. Then our bond aayega. This is ion, no?
Yes, sir.
Samajh mein aaya?
What's the Excuse me, sir.
Ah, batao.
So what's the electronic configuration of this chromium?
Chromium is a d block element. Atomic number is?
Yes, sir.
Atomic number of the chromium, how much? 24, no?
The 24.
Ah, 3s2, 4s2, 4s2, 3d, 5, 4s1, 3d, 5. Maximum electrons, how many? 6. Oxidation number is not, oxidation number is not exceeding plus 6, no? It's a group number.
Yes, it's not exceeding.
Not exceeding its group number. Chromium, transition element. This is the configuration. This is the configuration, is exceptional one. Instead of 3D4, 4S1, 3D5. I told the reason also in atomic structure. So why this configuration is exceptional? Right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so now is now here if you write the formula of the compound, we use Stark notation. Stark notation of the formula. Stark notation of the element. Stark notation of the element in the given formula. That means here the oxidation number is represented in the form of Stark notation. So oxidation number of the element represented in the form of Stark notation given by the scientist of that element in the given formula. For example, if I write MnO2, okay, MnO2 manganese dioxide. So what is the oxidation state of the manganese in this? Simple, X plus minus 2 into 2 is equal to 0. Since the compound is a neutral.
4.
So 4.
4.
In the formula, we should write Mn after Roman number, we should write 4. O2 we should write. So if you write Mn4O2 and the Roman number which is coming after the element, parenthesis of the element, so in the bracket if you mention the Roman number, represent the Stark notation, the oxidation number of that particular element represented in the form of Stark notation. Mostly this type of Stark notation we write metal complex compounds to represent the oxidation state of the transition metal. Okay, so here if I write Pb4Cl4, this is called plumbic chloride. The Roman number indicate what? The oxidation state of the Pb, not chlorine. And if I write AuCl, Au1Cl, RS chloride this is. If I write Au, this is if I write RC chloride along with this oxidation notation. That means here the oxidation number of the particular element in the formula written after the element with a Roman number. So that represents what means oxidation number of that particular element, particular transition metal we say. Okay, so and you can write HgCl2 bracket 2Cl2 mercury chloride, not mercurius. If you write mercurius, Hg2Cl2, here you should write 1. Mercurius.
Sir, highest one is known as OIC and lowest one is US.
Yeah, simple, already you learnt. For the same element, for example, Pb, if you write plus 2, plumbus, OUS. Pb plus 4 if you write plumbic, for the same element lower oxidation state is S, higher oxidation state is IC. We follow RS, RIC, plumbus, plumbic, stannous, stannic. For example, SnCl2, Roman number 2, stannous. SnCl4, stannic. So this is the oxidation number in terms of the Stark notation we write, particularly for the chlorides and particularly for the oxides. For example, you write ferrous oxide. You can write ferric oxide. Like this notations. So oxidation number, a particular element in the given formula represented with the star notation like this. So that means if you write the oxidation number in terms of the star notation of that particular element in the given formula, you'll understand. So what is the oxidation state of that particular element? By looking at the formula, you'll understand. Okay. Right. So this is the star notation. So oxidation number, star notation. Now, very important concept. Now I am going to explain. Based on this oxidation number, we'll classify the chemical reactions, particularly redox reactions, chemical reactions. So classify the chemical reactions into number one, combination reactions. Number two,
displacement.
Number three, decomposition. Number four,
double displacement.
Okay, and double displacement we'll discuss later on. Disproportionate reactions. Yes, disproportionate reactions, combination, displacement, decomposition, disproportionate chemical reactions. So these are the four types mainly we'll classify. So because these reactions follow the redox reactions principle. So now one by one we'll discuss what is the combination with the suitable examples we'll discuss. Combination reactions, element compound, combination reactions takes place. So example I'm writing, example is chemical combination is H2 plus O2 to H2O combination. Different elements combined to form the compound. HCl, H2 plus Cl2 forms into HCl. 2HCl is the combination. CH4 plus oxygen, burning of this hydrocarbon will form CO2 and water is the combination. Combination reactions we say. Magnesium plus fluorine gas to form MgF2 is the combination. When sodium burned in the presence of oxygen to form sodium oxide is the combination we say. Sodium oxide. These are all combination reactions. And these combination reactions follows the principle is said to be redox principle. That means these reactions are associated with oxidation as well as reduction reactions. They follow. Now, so how these reactions follow these redox principle? Now we'll check. H2 plus O2 to H2O. Since here hydrogen is taken what form? Elemental form. Oxidation state is zero. Already I told. Since oxygen is taken in the form of element, oxidation state is zero. Oxidation number is zero. Since in this compound since the polar compound, so unequal sharing, hydrogen will be plus 1 and oxygen will be minus 2. Now hydrogen and hydrogen both, so elemental form 0 changing from how much means 0 to how much plus 1. And again oxygen changing from 0 to how much means negative. Now tell me 0 to plus 1 losing or gaining?
Losing.
Losing. That means oxidation we say. And 0 to minus 2 is a gaining. Reduction.
Yes sir.
See in the equation you have to balance the charges. If you balance the charges, you'll be knowing how to balance the equation also. See here, hydrogen plus 1 I mentioned here. Oxygen is minus 2. So balance the charges, opposite charges. So multiply this plus 1 into 2. Plus 2 aega. This minus 1 multiplied with 1, minus 2 aega. So what integers are you taking? Here 1 you are taking, here 2 you are taking, right? So this is the coefficient I am using here. Samajh mein aa raha sabko? So how I got the coefficient number? How I got the coefficient number in print of H2O? So I got this coefficient number 2 integer. So this plus 1 I multiplied with 2. This minus 2 I am multiplying with 1. Clear everyone? Are you listening to me?
Yes sir. Yes, sir.
So, how this coefficient number I got? Did you understand? For the equating of these charges, I used the integer. What I used? Integer. What is the integer? 2 I used. And here I use the 1. So oxygen is 1. And hydrogen, if I take 2 means 2 into 2, 4. So hydrogen atoms how many? 4 atoms. I hope it is clear now. Next example I will take.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
So there were 2 hydrogen atoms, but you take. Took only 1. It should have been plus 2.
See here. Okay, understood. So here H2 and here acha balancing. This side 2H2O, right? Here is 0, here is 0, here is how much means. So plus 1 I took, oxygen is minus 2 I took. Okay, oxidation state. And in order to balance the charge, so how much? So I took the 2 I took, here is 1 I took. I'll tell you now. So if I take the 2 number, here I place 2 number, here means oxygen is 1. But here hydrogens 4, here hydrogens are 2. The same number I am putting here.
Yes, here sir. Yes, sir. Charge is getting balanced.
And so now another example I'll take for the combination CH4 gas burning with oxygen to form CO2 plus H2O. So in methane, carbon oxidation state how much?
Plus 4.
Plus 4 or minus 4?
Minus 4.
Minus 4.
Minus 4.
Hydrogen is plus 1. So minus 4 plus 1 multiplied with how much 4, no?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
So such that you get 0 neutral.
Yes, sir. Neutral 0.
Compound is neutral, no? Minus 4 and plus 4. Oxygen is 0 here. In this carbon, plus 4, right? Carbon dioxide.
Yes.
Carbon is plus 4. Oxygen is how much? Minus 2. Minus 2 into 2. Minus 4. Hydrogen is plus 1, oxygen is minus 2. So now hydrogen atoms are balanced here. So how many hydrogen atoms here? So this 1 is multiplied with the 2. But hydrogen atoms here, how many? 4. So if I take 2 means 2s2, 4 aega. Okay, now what I'll do means this is minus 4, here is plus 4. Abhi batao carbon ka condition. Changing the oxidation state minus 4 to how much? Plus 4. What is this? Oxidation?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Oxidation.
Now oxygen changing from how much? 0 to how much? Minus 2. Reduction. So now tell me, carbon oxidation state changing from minus 4 to plus 4, how many electrons difference?
8 electrons
difference. But oxygen 0 to minus 2, how much difference?
2
difference. So that means 2 electrons. This is 2 is multiplied with 4. Number of electrons are equated?
Yes, sir. Number of electrons.
So the number of electrons are equated means, so this 4 I should use here. So already oxygen atoms are 2, here 2. Now number of oxygen atoms, how many? Is that equation balanced? What do you say? Number of oxygen atoms are balanced or not?
Yes, sir, balanced.
Number of oxygen atoms are balanced. That means?
Yes.
So based on the oxidation number, based on the track of the electrons, it is easy to balance the chemical equation. If you track the electrons and if you just to adjust the oxidation states of the element, it is easy to balance the chemical equation, no?
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
We have multiplied 4 in downwards, then how we multiply division divide in two forms, like 2H2 and 2O2.
So here. First, the carbon, what is happening for the carbon? Carbon is losing. How many electrons are losing? 8 electrons are losing. So who is gaining 8 electrons? Oxygen is gaining. So which is gaining the electrons, oxygen or hydrogen? See, in the equation, which is getting reduction? Which element is getting reduction?
Oxygen
is getting reduction. That means gaining. But oxygen places are at two places, no? One is at CO2, one is at H2O, no?
Yes.
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 So that's why here what I'm doing, 0 to minus 2 is changing in both cases. In both cases is minus 2. So that's why here what I'm doing, here is minus 2 and here is also minus 2. And totally what I am doing in case if I take here, so minus 2 means here multiplied with how much? 2. Here is multiplied with how much? 2 only, no?
Yes, sir.
So this 2 number I wrote here, this 2 number already is there, subscript. And
yes,
total,
sir.
How many? 4 I took here, 2 into 2, 4. I
yes,
think you
sir.
Got the answer.
Yes, sir. Now it's correct.
So this is the chemical combination. So if you track the oxidation number, electrons transfer from where the electrons are moving and which atom is gaining, if you know, easy to balance the chemical equation. If I write Mg plus F2, solid gas, what happened here? This is elemental form. Elemental form plus 2 minus 1 into 2. Changing from how much? 0 to magnesium is 0 to sorry plus 2. What is oxidation?
Yes.
Magnesium getting oxidation. Fluorine.
Yes, sir.
Getting reduction.
Yes, sir.
Fluorine is getting reduction now.
Yes, sir.
That means electrons are transferring from where? The competitive transfer, magnesium to fluorine. Less electrons taken due to more electronegative. Always electrons migrate. Less electronegative to more electronegative. And this will gain positive charge, this will be gaining negative charge, no? Always.
Yes, sir.
Okay, now this is chemical combination is over. Next one is chemical displacement. Displacement. Already we discussed the chemical displacement. There are two types. Metal displacement. Number two, non-metal and non-metal displacement is a third one also there. Metal and non-metal displacement, one third category. Displacement, three types of chemical reactions. So follows the three reactions follow. Redox principle, this follows. Now we discuss metal. Example, metal. You can give example. Already we discussed it. What is the example? Zinc plus CuSO4 aqua solution, CuSO zinc sulfate.
Plus Cu.
So zinc oxidation state is 0, copper oxidation state is a plus 2 here, zinc plus 2 here, copper is 0. So I am assigning the oxidation states 0 to changing to plus 2. Loss of electrons how many? 2. Oxidation now?
Yes, sir.
And here is copper plus 2 changing into 0, getting reduction. Getting the reduction, we say. And sulfate is minus 2, remain same. This is the spectate ion. Then ionic equation is Zn plus Cu plus 2 Aq gives rise to Zn plus 2 Aq plus copper. And from this reaction, what we understand is that zinc is more active metal than the copper. Okay?
Sir, how to get the charge of sulfate? How to get the charge of sulfate?
Sulfate ion, no, compound radical, this is. What is the charge of the sulfate? Compound radical, minus 2 only, no?
Yes, sir.
So
if it given directly, then how we can determine its charge?
See, how generally what happened, the copper sulfate and zinc sulfate, so they dissociate in the water, Cu plus 2 and SO4 minus 2, right?
Yes, sir.
So definitely, if it is aqueous solution means, In aqueous solution, what will be the ions? Copper, cupric ion. If the zinc sulfate means zinc plus 2 ion. So here the sulfate is not undergoing any change. Only the metal is undergoing change only, no? Displacement.
Yes, sir.
So now, non-metal displacement. Example, you take example Ki solution, potassium iodide solution, aqueous solution, and into this potassium iodide solution, if you pass the chlorine gas, so what? When the chlorine gas is passed into potassium iodide solution, so what happen? You will get potassium chloride iodine gas. We will get. Now potassium oxidation state is a plus 1, iodine is a minus 1, chlorine is a 0, potassium is a plus 1, chlorine is a minus 1, iodine is 0. Now keep track of the electrons. Potassium plus 1, potassium plus 1, oxidation state is same now. Now potassium is a spectator ion. Samajh mein aa raha sabko? Potassium is a spectator ion because its oxidation state in the reactant and in the product is same, no? Am I audible to you?
Yes, sir.
The potassium, if you observe the potassium, its oxidation state remains same in the reactant, in the product.
Yes.
So then it is to be spectator ion. Spectator ion, we say. The spectator ion means whose oxidation state remains same throughout the reaction. It is called spectator ion, whether it is a positive or negative ion. In the previous reaction, sulfate was the spectator ion. अभी देखो, आयोडीन इज अ माइनस वन नो हियर, सो आयोडीन इज चेंजिंग माइनस वन टू हाउ मच जीरो नो, सो टू इनटू माइनस, सो टू इनटू माइनस वन मींस जीरो, हाउ मेनी इलेक्ट्रॉन्स डिफरेंस, सो दिस इज रिडक्शन और ऑक्सीडेशन, ऑक्सीडेशन माइनस टू टू जीरो मींस लूजिंग और गेनिंग, बताओ
the gaining. It's a losing.
Carefully, see. Minus 1, 2 minus 1, changing into I2. So, giving how many electrons? 2 electrons. What we call that?
Oxidation.
Yes. Iodide is changing into iodine gas. This is, there is a so much difference between, these are in the form of aqueous. This is the form of gas. This is a neutral. This is ion. This is the form of potassium iodide. I minus. I2. So 2 into minus 1, no? 2 into minus 1. The 2 electrons are coming out.
Yes, sir.
So this is decreasing of negative valency. Decreasing of negative valence is oxidation. Decreasing of negative valence is called oxidation. Right? So now chlorine changing from 0 to how much chlorine? Minus 1, no? Chlorine changing from what? 0 to minus 1 into 2. 2 Cl minus. Oxidation or reduction? Is that oxidation or reduction? Batao.
Reduction.
Reduction. Yes. So since the chlorine is very active non-metal, displacing the iodine, Then you are getting pure hydrogen gas.
Yes, sir.
So if you want to prepare iodine gas, you can follow this method. And if you want to bromine, you take KBr. Bromine aayega. So from this reaction, what we understand from this reaction, fluorine is more reactive than chlorine, chlorine is more reactive than bromine, bromine is more reactive than iodine. Halogens, F2 is more reactive than Cl2, Cl2 is more reactive than Br2, Br2 is more reactive than I2. Order, reactivity order, humko milega. Yes?
Yes.
So now, I'll take metal versus non-metal displacement. Last one. Metal versus non-metal displacement reaction. So example, we'll take active metal plus HCl. Magnesium plus HCl, H2SO4. Iron plus HCl. So predict the products.
ZnCl2 plus H2.
H2 gas, hydrogen gas. And
MgSO4.
MgSO4 plus H2 gas,
H2.
Hydrogen gas. And FeCl2, ferrous chloride plus H2 gas. So what does this reaction tell us about? Metal reaction with the acids. This is the common property of acids. Hydrogen chloride plus zinc. Sulfuric acid with this magnesium. Iron plus with HCl. So these are the active metals. React with the acids, they produce their respective salts. Hydrogen gas comes out. And tell me, if I take gold, if I take silver, do you get hydrogen gas? See, if I use Au, if I use Pt, if I use copper, do you get the hydrogen gas with these acids? 9. Why?